get the show started. Y'all looking good? Y'all smell good? Shut up. I'm about to introduce the band. Before we get the show started, they're gonna open up with a couple of numbers for you. I'm gonna introduce them one by one. On the bass guitar, we got my young partner, Tay. Tay, come to the stage. Next up to the stage, we got on the drums, King Bank. And on the piano, on the keys, we got my man, Lex. And Way Too Funny, comedy show guest. I would like to introduce you to the Avengers. Please rock with them as they give you some original numbers tonight. Right now, just like this. I just told this dumb motherfucker to come out here and say, thank y'all for coming out to the Way Too Funny comedy show starring Michael Coyer, and I bring to you your host, Boston Comedian. This dumb motherfucker came out here and said, and cut the music down. What the fuck is wrong with these people? Damn it, he ain't even doing it for free. What the fuck? He doing what free people supposed to do. Yeah, Pastor, can you rebuke him, Pastor? Can you get this motherfucker two shaman a house? This motherfucker needs some help right here. You done threw off my whole mojo, Negro. What the hell is wrong with you? Do you see somebody out there you like, boy? I know you can't hear neither. What's up, Ben? Y'all late motherfuckers too. I paid y'all. You niggas come late. We had a sound check. I put y'all on Facebook and shit, and you niggas come in late. What the hell's wrong with y'all? I told y'all this shit for real. Yeah, I know the people can hear me, but fuck it. I'm gonna talk to y'all right now. First, you skinny fat. Hey, this skinny fat, this motherfucker gonna tell me he not fat. You fat. If you fat right here, nigga, you fat. He talking about what about this and these. Motherfucker, you fat. Ain't no fucking changing that. And this nigga... Come here, Lex. Yeah, you little nappy dread. This nigga need a retwist job so bad. If you don't take that money and get your shit twisted at the roots immediately. And then King Bay. I don't know if y'all know King Bay, the most controversial light-skinned motherfucker on Facebook. And you gonna come here with this old casual-ass outfit. You told me, I say, what you gonna wear? I asked my skinny friend, what you gonna wear? So I know how to get clean, this motherfucker. He say, don't even trip, big homie, I'ma kill him. And this nigga come in here, that's what he say. All right, throw that trip, big homie, you know how I do. And this nigga come in with this fucking Illuminati shirt on. He got a motherfucking, this motherfucker got the motherfucking, the fucking food chart. You know the fucking triangle vegetables at the top and all that bullshit. You don't wear no healthy shit to my show. Nigga, I'm fat, nigga. What's up, ladies? Y'all with them, so y'all part of the reason why they late. And y'all standing over here looking like backup singers for the Pointer Sisters. Y'all make sure these niggas on time from now on. All right, who all, you a girlfriend, you a girlfriend too? What the fuck? You what? A fiance, that don't mean shit. I'm a fiance, and we finna take our Section 8 to Texas. They move every year. Every motherfucking year. How the fuck this bitch keep moving? I don't know how you get Section 8 file taxes. That's not fair. For real, I don't think that shit fair. Motherfucker on Section 8, my bitch got $10,000 back. I sold it so fast, you know I need a new motor in my car. I called my baby mama, I say, I know, you and your man, y'all need to get your truck out the shop and shit, but you get your taxes though? I need that 250 at least, because I take goddamn well good care of my son. I need 250, motherfucker. I need 250. You know she lied to me, though. She's a dirty wench. She thought she was safe coming here tonight. I've been telling her coming 4 years. This is her first night. She finna get it in here. Fuck that. Fuck that. She know what she told me. Antoinette said something wrong with my tax refund. She got to do it. And 2 days later, my son come over with a new outfit. I said, oh, this bitch got a check. On me. And you know, she ain't shit. She gonna get him a shirt and some shoes. The pants was old than a motherfucker. For real, you ain't gonna never meet no parents like me, my baby mama, and her new man, her new baby daddy. For real, me and that nigga was beefing. Oh, we had a problem. He thought I was chasing his booty. I didn't want no more pussy from her. I was fucking all her friends at work. Oh, yeah. Oh, fat nigga. Oh, yeah. Let a bitch get... Come here. On me. I was fucking all her friends at work. So when she cheated, I wasn't mad. Hell no. I just want to know my son good. She gonna play with the son. Have me and this nigga fighting and arguing, pulling guns. We fighting at the emergency room. My son in there finger big as a motherfucker. The people, I'm in the emergency room. I got my new bitch. My baby mama in there pregnant. We beefing. She don't like the new bitch. You know what I'm saying? I don't know why she like the new bitch. The new bitch wanted to hold, but I wouldn't let her. So I don't know why she like the new bitch. She wasn't no benefit to me. Bitch had yaki weave. She didn't have Malaysia. She wasn't no benefit for me. Now listen. No, y'all listen. I'm venting right now. I got some shit on my mind. All right, So we beefing at the motherfucking, at the emergency room and shit, right? This shit done got ugly. It started at Antoinette house. For real, Antoinette messy ass, y'all. Fuck it, Antoinette messy. The one, she messy as a motherfucker. She called me down to her house, knowing my baby mama there. My baby mama, this is how the fight started. The nigga, and my nigga Booty don't even know how it started. We just been out here beefing. He don't even know how it started. We best friends. Now that's my nigga. I shoot a nigga for that nigga, that's my nigga. But if y'all know who we being, you'd be like, ooh, somebody need to get both of them $1 million. Black men, don't do that. So I went to Antoinette house and baby mama out there. You know what I'm saying? That year, she only got like $1,500 for her taxes. So I gave her $1,500 to get the car. Little Mazda 626 shit, right? So we in Antoinette's house. She do the most jankiest shit you can say to a good father, y'all. This is the worst shit you can say to a good father. I'm not a deadbeat father. I'm not a partway father. This Wayne's going to tell me Buddha his daddy now. I had my gun, right? I wasn't gonna shoot her. I pulled it out and turned it back because I wanted to bust the window out the car. She drove off. This bitch got away. So, no, I didn't fall, motherfucker. I'm balanced. I've been fat. I ain't get here later. Motherfucker. Now, listen. So, she speed off to her house. I speed behind her. So, I know she calling the nigga. At the time, he was the nigga. That's my nigga Buddha now. She calling the nigga. So when I get there to the house, I'm like, oh yeah, I know this nigga gonna be ready. This nigga a Haitian, mind you. So you know Haitians gotta think they crazy right now because Rick Ross and them and shit. So this nigga run outside with a chopper. I'm like, this nigga got a chopper, god damn. Only got a little 40. I'm like, all right, nigga, I'm gonna be back. So I leave, right? Time go by. It's Friday night. I'm in the bed with somebody else, baby mama, just like him. So I'm thinking I ain't tripping. I understand what he going through. I got another nigga bitch too. He mad. All right, so my phone rings Friday. Hey, what's up, my nigga? Hey, man, your son, man, he be missing you. What would you do if I snap? My son, what this nigga doing calling me about my son at 1 o'clock on a motherfucking Friday? So I go off a little bit. He go off a little bit. The nigga tell me, I don't do no fighting. You know me, well, goddammit, if I yell back, we both run. So I tell him, well, look, my nigga, me and you both done laid with that bitch over there. When I get off the phone, you ask her who she gonna worry about. Pick up. This nigga called me back. Hey, nigga. I said, oh, shit, my sister called me. She a little crackhead bitch. She called me. Okay, it's not crack. My mama smoked crack. She don't matter. Okay? So my sister called, she nervous and shit. She like, my baby mama Shamika, she go over there and tell her, I don't know what Buddha gonna do. He Haitian. My sister called me. She smoked out, mouth moving 95 miles. Say, you gotta do something. This nigga Haitian, he might do something. You better get this nigga right now. Long story short, we go back and forth with this shit. One day his son come to my house for my son's birthday, and I fell in love with the nigga's son. And now that's like my best friend. You ain't gonna never meet two niggas that done really played with guns with each other. That's tighter than me and this man right here. So y'all make some round of applause for my nigga Buddha right there. That's my nigga. Don't trip. Don't trip. We gonna get Shamika ass back. We gonna tag team on her ass. We don't like it no more, but like, all right, my nigga, let's set up. We gonna run the train on there, put it on porn tube. No, I'm just playing. Y'all crazy, dude. But y'all having a good time? You told what? Did you say something? I hate people with your motherfucking body type, Negro. You fit fucker. I hate you. You can do burpees and cherry pickers and shit. I can do cherry picker. Let me get that off the top of your drink before you let it go to the bottom. Fuck you. Motherfucker, I could do some shit you can't do. For real, I bet you can't smother a girl from the top. Your girl's stronger than you, nigga. She can't hold all this, nigga. She, this motherfucker don't get out right. Mercy! Why you leave me, baby? Hey, fellas, anybody in the room stop liking a girl because she don't like the kids? It is not that you don't like kids, but it's just that she don't teach her kids shit. Like my mom, like my auntie used to say about me, you motherfuckers ain't got no home training. These girl kids is wild. I don't like these motherfuckers. Am I wrong? Listen, I feed these little motherfuckers. I clothe these little motherfuckers. I put them in the best shit. And these motherfuckers can't even tell me good morning in the morning. Motherfucker look at me like I ate all the cereal. I don't eat breakfast because before I go to sleep, I go get me a motherfucking French toast slam for $6 from Denny's. I ain't gonna eat the cereal, you little bad motherfucker. They don't speak to me. So am I wrong if I took back Christmas presents and birthday presents shit that I bought? Tell me if I'm wrong, I wanna know. I'm asking, are y'all scared? I ain't gonna talk about you for your opinion. Hey, is y'all humping back there? Pup, I swear to God, if you fuck that little light-skinned girl in this theater, you is getting a decent exposure right there. Get your hand from up her skirt. Your finger goes stank, nigga. Light girls got an odor. What? Light girls got an odor. I don't give a fuck. Everybody here know you ain't never fucking no light girl. Oh, you got a light girl right now, huh? That don't mean nothing. Her daddy something else. You ain't say her daddy and her mama black, so somebody not, motherfucker. And that's a damn shame she mixed and she still got a track. That shit get on my nerves. If you oil that shit, you don't need that shit. And another thing, ladies, before you get this goddamn sew-on weave and shit, y'all need to make sure that your bun wrap is good. I get tired of a week later that goddamn ponytail be sticking up out the back of that goddamn weave. For real, looking like she got a tumor. Look at this bitch got a tumor. That's a motherfucking tumor. What's up, Big Bill? Hey, did you buy two seats? If you didn't buy two seats, I need $25 more from you. You was taking up two seats in a row. I don't care. I like a motherfucker fatter than me because then I can talk about you and not talk about myself. That nigga right there can't put baby powder on. I'm sorry, Bill. You a big motherfucker, man. You big as a motherfucker. Hey, y'all should see the seat in that nigga car. For real, that nigga done set the seat pillows down to the rack. The whole, everything else gone. Hey, that nigga got leather on top of some metal. Nigga, a metal rack. For real. Hey, yeah. Every time that nigga gonna get in this truck, he get, trade me in. Trade me in. Trade me in now. I don't wanna ride with you anymore. Trade me in. Trade me in. Y'all don't think it's funny when I talk about other fat people? I would talk about y'all. Y'all better laugh at the fat white dude. He got bad credit. He's not a good white dude to have. Don't worry about him. He can't even tip good. I'm just playing. Y'all ready to start the show? We're gonna bring out the first comedian, get this show rolling. If you was here last time, you seen him. You're gonna see him a couple more times. This is a good friend of mine. I forced him into comedy. Not really. Yes, we did. AJ, we kind of forced him, huh? For real, he told me you'd be making him get up, tell him, hey, you sleep, you gotta go to the show tonight. For real, thank you. I appreciate that, because he helped me, I'm gonna help him. So y'all make no, it's a whole bunch of noise for this mug right here. This is my man, give it up for my man, Twix the Comedian.
Can I get a drink, please, woman? Can I get a drink? Give it for the DJ, y'all. Boss roasting his ass. I got some issues. I'm gonna talk about them. Can I talk about my issues?
Yeah.
Where the fuck is the plane at? Where's the goddamn plane at? Like, I'm not gonna talk about the people because we don't know what happened to them, so God bless their soul. But I know y'all feel like I feel when you watch the news and there's a big ass plane with over 200 people and you're thinking, where the fuck a plane at? Don't nobody on the plane got an iPhone that got to find my iPhone. Do you feel me? They covering up something, man. This is some bullshit. Like, when I get home from work, I can't wait to get home and turn on the news. So I turn on CNN breaking news. We still haven't found the plane. How is that breaking news? 3 weeks, they still ain't, that's breaking news. They done made all kind of 3D simulations and shit. They made cartoon animation. Channel 8, you know, they got money like CNN. They got Lego set put together, dropping the Play-Doh and shit. They gonna come out with a movie. Before they even find the plane, I bet they have a movie out to make money, I guarantee that. And y'all know who gonna play in the movie, too.
The new movie featuring the top actor in the world, Samuel L. Jackson.
Where's the goddamn plane? That's all you're gonna say, y'all. Y'all see him on we was getting interviewed that time, and the guy said, "So Samuel, how'd it feel doing the Super Bowl commercial, doing the Matrix?" He was like, "We ain't the same niggas. He and all the niggas be the same nigga." Did y'all see that? I'm not making that up. This is real life stuff. I got issues. I got an issue with big girls always taking pictures like this on Instagram. Let me give you a hint. If you take a picture that's like this, we know you big. That's what big girls do. I don't know what angle, I don't know where y'all study this. I don't know what math class y'all took, but they ain't telling me the obtuse angle of making you look skinny. You still look big. You just look big for your face first, so your face looks bigger. That's the way they're trying to match the whole. I got issues, man. No bullshit, I got some issues, man. I got you, but my wife, I love her to death, man. We married for 5 years, give it to my wife, man. But I got some real issues, man. My wife, since she came out here when she's 14, right? It's certain things as Americans that we're used to, but reality is dumb as hell. But since we're used to it, we don't think twice about it. Until somebody from another country asks you about it, and you try to explain it, and you can't explain it. Let me give you a scenario. True stories. I tell all true stories. We go to New Orleans, right? You're watching an old school concert. Cameo come on stage. I'm pumped up. I'm telling about Cameo. Baby, Cameo's the shit. He comes out, Harum Darling, right? Come on stage. She said, baby. I'm like, what's up? I'm like, she's like, baby, I'm like, why does he have underwear over his pants? So I'm trying to explain this shit. I'm like, baby, that's Cameo, you know what I mean? Right.
I love your wife.
I love her too. I love her too, that's why I married her, but, you know, she aight. I got some issues, man. I got some health issues. I just had a big surgery, and I'm still here. You can give it up, you clap. It's a kind of personal surgery. The best way I can explain it is they took the fish out of my sea. They tied my tubes. I'm singing that song now, no new kids, no new kids, no new kids, no, no, no. Stealing child support from the first one. Y'all got me. So, this is my issue. Another issue I have is racism. I can't stand the fact of racism. We divide ourselves so much. I'm black, you white, he's Mexican, I'm fat, I'm skinny, he's dark, he's light. All that's bullshit, man. We all the same inside. You know what I'm saying? Clap for that, clap for that. That's all the non-racist people clapping. People ain't clapping like, I can't stand them. But for real, there's certain incidents that happen that make you realize that we're closer than we think. Like, for instance, true life story, JB's in here? How do y'all say JB's in here? A girl go, woo! Somebody's getting dick tonight. No, but me and JB's go to the Nello's Mall, right? True life stories. To the Nello's Mall, we pull up, we feeling good, we got the car, right? And all we hear is, help, help! He's like, shut up, bitch, shut up! I'm like, what the fuck? And everybody's like, looking at us, because people out in the parking lot, they're looking at us like, can we stop the situation? So we're looking for her, we hear it, and it's like, she's like, and the dude's cussing around, bitch, da 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 da, right? So we finally see the situation. It's a white dude, like meth head, got the little white beater on, like a picture, not like a cool white beater, like the ones that got pictures on, like a picture of a tank, on the back, like, made in USA. A little ass John Stockton shorts, you know what I'm saying? Mismatch socks and shit. So he's choking her out in the middle of the parking lot. He's like, choking her out, like, shut up, bitch. Ah! So me and JB, people looking at us like, we're the black dudes in the parking lot. We can stop this, right? So I'm like, come on, man. So we go over there. Hey, homeboy. Hey, chill out. Hey, chill out. So while he's choking her out, like, you, chill out. He lets her go. He says, excuse me, bro. My bitch was fucking up, okay? When your bitch fucks up, do you check her now or do you check her later? You check her now, bro! Oh, bullshit. His little balls came out like a blowfish. Now! BJB's like, God damn, he's right. He's fucking right. I'm like, that was some nigga shit right there. Way more like than I thought. Should I have a pillow fight? What is this? But that's my time, man. Enjoy the show, man. I love y'all. Woo, woo, woo. Townsville. Why the fuck is the DJ? What type of shit is this, that nigga? I'm going to tell one more joke, because he here. All right, can I tell more? All right. I ain't gonna do it. Give it up, y'all.
Bring my motherfucking pimp hat. All the bitches that's hoes in the house say, ho. Oh, bitches don't want to claim their profession tonight, huh? Nah, bitch, I seen you on Boulder Highway, bitch. Yeah, bitch, that was me, sweaty, you bitch. Sweaty, Schmitty P, bitch. I'm Schmitty to the motherfucking P. You know what I'm saying? And this is what happens when your mama smoke crack after she have you, baby. She didn't smoke it with me, baby. She smoked it after me, baby. You know what I mean? What y'all laughing at? Y'all don't like the way my belly hang from the low?
Look at that.
You can't see my dick, but you can see my navel. Yeah. Ben, hey, you niggas come up here and play some shit for me, baby. This nigga Bay done left again. Oh my fucking God. Baby, I'm hey, what this nigga at, baby? These niggas here, I try to hire some niggas, baby. We had a sound check rehearsal, baby. I tell them exactly what the fuck I want them to do, baby. And this nigga done walked away. Is this show for him or for me, baby? Where the nigga at, baby? Where he at? All the way in the front, baby? Hey, Tommy, sit your handicap ass down. I got something like you, boy. What? Are you embarrassed all the shit you talk on Facebook? You be fucking with people out there on Facebook. You want nobody to know you got a cane, nigga?
I ain't gonna do it, motherfucker. I can do some shit you don't do, though. Fuck, cause you dead. Between the race, nigga.
You can't fuck like I fuck, boy. Hey, man, fuck that nigga on the drug. Hey, man, drop my shit, man. I'm so disappointed. Y'all got to excuse these new niggas, man. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, baby. Now listen, y'all. I had the DJ Google some of them songs. Ain't that what them young boys do, Googling? I had him Google my mama's crack smoking greatest hits right here, baby. For real, baby. All these songs he can play right here, I can tell you from the years of 84 to 89 exactly what my mama would do when certain songs would play for you, baby. Like this right here, y'all hear this? Turn that shit up for me, baby. Turn that shit up for me. Yeah. This was my mama cleanup music right here. You know what I mean? When my mama hit that thing two times, and her mouth get to transforming, y'all know that crack shit. Oh, she can sweep like a motherfucker to this. She can do some shit to this. These niggas, cut that off, boy. Ladies and gentlemen, I sincerely apologize because I done called this nigga 7 times, so I think I need to talk about his punk ass. Vay, come out here. Where you at, Vay? You done fucked up my whole production, you son of a bitch. No, ain't no ooh to none of that shit. I can't believe this. When you hire a nigga and you pay a nigga to do something for you and the nigga don't do it right. I don't care, he's late. He was supposed to be right there and I was changing, goddammit. And he gonna come now. Where you been? Come here, boy. Come sit your ass. Right here, boy. You done fucked up my show, boy. Come here, yeah, bring your little cute violent ass here. Yeah, I'ma tell a story about this some bitch right here. He fuck up my shit, I'ma fuck up his shit. You know what I'm saying? Most people call having a strong opinion, they call you nowadays being a hater. So I'm about to hate. What? Fuck it. Where you been, boy? Where your motherfucking ass been, boy? You was not in the bathroom, motherfucker. You got on skinny jeans with a Valesame bag, goddammit. You do not go to the bathroom in skinny jeans. That shit hold everything in, nothing out. So what bathroom was you in, goddammit? You can't piss in no skinny jeans, boy. You have to get naked to piss in some shit like that. Huh? I bet you around your ass is just as purple as a motherfucker wearing them jeans. You make skinny jeans, them is oxygen decreasing jeans, boy. Pick your head up. No, pick your head up. Cause we on Facebook banging on niggas and shit. Nah, sit your ass down. Nah, don't you move. Fuck that. You fuck me up, I'm fucking you up. This is a spontaneous show. Ain't no script to this shit, goddammit. Now, we had some plans set up for you to be out here. What happened, boy? What happened? What you do to this boy before you came to this show? You, over there, with the Princess Leia hat do. That ain't, you ain't even got no fucking, I'm talking about your girl too. She ain't even got, she like a Wookiee by the hat.
Little skinny ass. How y'all, ooh, if y'all have a baby together, that motherfucker gonna be butterscotch. Y'all have a new Blue Bell baby flavor. Y'all. You not shit, nigga. You not shit, nigga. You made me look bad, nigga. I already look bad, look at me. I ain't tripping, I'm bending over because your girl gonna see my ass. And I let her see it. Did you see the tissue in it, baby? Baby, did you see the tissue in it, baby? For real. I tried to have sex with a fat bitch one day. She pulled out her panties, she had tissue in her ass. She talking about, and when I sweat, boo-boo sometimes slide out. Bitch, you got to get the fuck up out of here. Cold part is a whole bunch of girls in here that do that shit. Hey, for real, all right, fuck it. We gonna keep it gangster. Older people in the room, excuse my vulgarity, or whatever that big word is you're supposed to use. My vulgaricity, make up some shit on y'all ass. For real, hey fellas, if your girl wearing a panty liner and it's not time for her cycle, she got an infection. She has had a motherfucking infection. Go sit your punk ass down over there by your instrument. You sit by your instrument, not by your lady. Fuck that. You like to wander off. Like I said, though, she's wearing a panty liner for no reason, fella. She has an infection. How come girls always try to blame their bacteria infection on the men? We can't get bacteria infection, urinary tract infection. You got built up back there. Somebody rubbed up against it and it flared up. You had that shit before, Jenny? You lying. Is it me as all the women from L.A. act like they bougie as a motherfucker? Hey, but be easy as kicking over this pillow. I swear to God, I'm not talking about y'all unprofessionally, so just leave it alone. Just leave it alone, because I'm not picking on y'all in generally, but I'm pretty sure y'all been lucid for a moment. Most women have been lucid, and the nigga that's with them just hope he don't run into the niggas that pointed out. For real. Hey, my nigga, if a nigga walked up to you right now, my nigga was like, hey, my nigga, I got this old under the bleacher video of your girl. You know she can suck dick and pop policies at the same time. That's a bad bitch. Pop policies and something. Her mouth dry. Ask your motherfucker, how is she doing this? Who else fucked with a fat girl when she opened her legs? She was pink right here on her thighs. I call that, this is what I call that. It's called OTD. OTD. Oven thigh disorder. Oven thigh disorder, cause she wiping like this and this shit get hot. You know what I'm saying? You seen it, even some skinny girls get it. You done seen it with the tights and shit, be all ate up, look like an old bath towel. For real, that you ain't got $7? You ain't got $7 there? I don't care, I said it. I don't care. You can say whatever you want to about me, I am comfortable with me. I think I blew the wood out of my frame the other night. What the fuck's wrong with y'all over there? Yo, me? Let me see, put the light over there. Who is that over there? Before I bring up somebody, who is that? Let me see. Hey there. Hey, I see you. Put the light on again. Hey there, Joy. Hey, Joy. Joy got that dick sucking gap. She got that dick sucking gap. She can put bottom lip on you at the bottom, and then she can do the shit look like that. Just do the... You ain't never had no gap head? Old player. I know you don't want to answer in front of her, but you here, fuck it. You ain't never had no gap head, like
like she give your head and whistle on that thing. Huh? Huh, for real? Real joy. Enjoying her phony, so she really know how to take it back to the... What? Fellas, if you ain't never grabbed your girl head and let it go, you not doing her right. What? What? I swear to God, I try to make every girl go, ha. Why you keep doing it? What? Are y'all laughing like y'all ain't never did it, ladies? If you ain't never did it, that's why your man cheating on you. And if you do it and he cheating on you, it's with another man. What? I don't care. Let me ask y'all this. This is bullshit. I believe in shit. Listen to me. Let me just ask y'all this. In America, right now in America, it is okay for two men to tongue kiss at the park while the boys playing football. That is some bullshit. But I can't do this at the swimming pool. See what I mean? See what I mean? America is fucked up. Two men can butt hump and I can't have my navel hanging out. It's shaved. It don't stain. No, see, that's that bullshit. That's the bullshit. Oh, you got, this nigga got cheap mics. He don't know how to DJ on time. This is bullshit. You know what I'm saying? And turn this motherfucker up, boy. Listen, and to all my gay women in attendance, I don't mean no offense to you, but I believe that if you a stud and the bitch say you a man, then you need to get beat up by six niggas first like an initiation. I don't give a fuck what y'all talking about. For real, because these little stud bitches got the game fucked up nowadays. I don't be seeing these bitches walking around here with tank tops and nipples hanging out and shit. Bitch, you can't wear no tank top and your nipples hard because it's cold outside. These little bulldagger bitches got it up. My grandma used to call it the U.S. Steel. We got goddamn bulldagger. They goddamn bulldagger. No disrespect to anyone that has that choice, but I do believe, my personal belief, I'm not trying to bestow this on you, I'm not a preacher, but I believe that if you want to be a man, you need to get jumped in, and then when you go to jail, you need to go to man jail. Yeah, for real. Did y'all know in jail, you could be gay when you get out, it never happened? Nobody got an answer, my man. Huh? For real, did y'all know that? For real, you can go to prison and you can fuck every nigga in cell block 8. And you can come home and give your girl a booty rash inside her cushion. That is a goddamn shame. That is a shame. This nigga's walking around this motherfucker hard as a motherfucker been in there fucking the shit out of Jacob. Gay as a motherfucker. You can say it again, a flaming faggot. For real, I don't care. I believe that they trying to ruin our kids in America. When y'all grew up, when we grew up in the time, all our cartoons produced masculinity. Remember the motherfucking Smurfs? You remember the Smurfs? The Smurfs had one bitch. She was a full-fledged hood rat. She was from Compton. That bitch was from Compton. I can hear Smurf in right now. I'm from LA, that's how we do it. That's what people say from that thing right now. For real, nowadays they got, y'all seen that shit? I ain't seen the cartoon, I seen the commercial. I swear to God, I wanted to bust my TV. Y'all seen that commercial for that shit, Chosen?
Y'all ain't seen that, the gay white rapper? It come on channel 13? Oh my Lord, look how they make us look, black people. Y'all better get y'all shit together.
Cause I live on Sunset Grand Canyon, it ain't too many of y'all up there by me, my shit good. But you West Side, in the beginning, the old North Town motherfuckers, y'all better get y'all shit together. Cause y'all was going down, shut the fuck up, you black bastard. Put the light on MA, you still can't see him. MA, murder black. Can't see nigga murder black? Murder black. That's the only nigga gotta get dressed to be able to see, sister. Fuck you. We gonna keep the show rolling. Shut up. Quit doing that. I don't love your dirt dick ass. See, you been in prison. You was one of them in there, you dirty bastard. Don't play with me like that, boy. I only been to the county.
He ain't never been in jail. The nigga in jail for his first time, they won't let, he don't know he gotta ask to use the phone. He be a scared motherfucker. A nigga with no street cred or Theodore. That's what I like to call scary niggas, Theodore. We gonna keep the show rolling. With no further ado, I give to y'all my man. He helped me get my start in comedy. He actually helped me get Michael Coyer here tonight. You know what I'm saying? So make noise for this unprofessional motherfucker, Mr. Mike P.
For the band, you niggas ain't about shit. I tried to tell boss, man, you can't be hiring the Republic Service as your band, my nigga. They got the pillows all on the ground and shit. This the side bitch Saturday show. With all these side bitches in here tonight. We got the older people in here, and they're like, come on, with all these N-words, these F-bombs. It's a family show, it's a lot of cussing and shit like that, so hey, how you doing tonight, Pops? You good? There's a lot of celebrities up in here tonight, man. Y'all give it up for the Desperate Housewives, Martin Luther King Boulevard. See them up in here. They niggas couldn't come to the show tonight because they on parole. They got a curfew and shit like that. Give it up for the Instagram girls. How y'all doing? No filter, bitch. I see you with the weave in the front, baby. How you doing? But is your life on track? Fucking lovely. This looks like Elizabeth Taylor's bathroom we in this morning. A lot of people was in here, the boss was in here talking about gays and kissing in the club and shit, man. We just gotta accept that shit for who they are, man. If you gay in here tonight, shit, give yourself a round of applause. I'm gonna tell y'all a real story. I'm coming out of 7-Eleven, right? This bad little broad walk in. You know what I mean? I'm like, damn, I'm looking at her. So all of a sudden, this stud stand up. I'm like, who bitch you looking at? And I knew she was a woman because she had a Ray Lewis jersey on and some lugs. And the 5 and the 2 was out a little bit like that. I'm like, that's a motherfucking female. I'm talking to nobody, I'm alright. In this days and times, you gotta fuck with gay people, man. Not like that, you know what I mean? Gay people got their shit together, you know what I mean? They do. When's the last time you ever been coming out of 7-Eleven and seen a gay homeless person? You ain't never seen that, my nigga. You ain't never seen that. A gay nigga outside of 7-Eleven like, excuse me, can I have a dollar? You ain't never seen no shit like that. Gay people got their shit together. Cause I'ma tell y'all some true shit, a true story. Knowing about homosexuality can save your life. Pox, let me tell you a story, man. I'm in the car. I'm in the car with this female, you know what I mean? I just met her, you know what I mean? She let me drive her little BMW. It was a 5 Series, you know what I mean? And while I'm driving with her, I'm letting her know she fucked with a real nigga. She ain't got shit to worry about, you know what I'm saying? I'm letting her know you fucked with a real nigga. I got 2 baby mamas. You fucked with a real nigga. I ain't got my license right now. Never had one. You fuck with a real nigga. So every car that go by, I bang on a... God damn. Shit, I bought that pussy for $40. That pussy go for $40. Shit, you see when that walk by? That's... She was on the tippy toes, too. Damn! That was some good pussy right there. Pops even looked at it. He was like, baby, you got my glasses. I need to look at it. I had holes in this one. Pop got the gray all in his beard. You know what I mean? Look like you been eating pussy with ashes on it. It's all good, dog. Valley, dog. So back to the story, though. So we in the car. So every car that rolled by, oh shit, look at Sharkeisha. Sharkeisha, no! Back to the story, like in the car, right? Driving her and shit. Feel me? I'm letting her know she ain't gotta worry about shit. She fuck with a real nigga. You know what I'm saying? So every car that go by, bang on the car. Watch where the fuck you go! Shut the fuck up! Whatever! Oh, fuck with a real nigga. Another car go by, bang on that car. I'm like, shut the fuck up! Watch where you go, whatever! Whatever! Nigga looked back at me and was like, pull over! And the girl I was riding with, she was like, what you gonna do? I mean, I ain't gotta worry about shit. I mean, what you gonna do? You gonna pull over? What you gonna do? I'm like, I'm gonna pull over. I don't give a fuck. I pulled over, got out my car. This nigga got out of his car. Looking like Kimbo Slice. I was like, so you just gonna cut me off to get my motherfucking attention? Bitch, do you see this nigga? For real, nigga? For real? Me, nigga, you just gonna cut me off? You know you can follow me on Twitter. He was like, you one of us? I was like, yes. He said, well, watch where the fuck you going. I was like, okay. Got back in the car. I was like, you thought I was going to fight that nigga? Shit. Finna fight shit. You know? I ain't gay in the least bit, but I know what I can and can't do. I ain't gay. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I got 2 baby mamas. Could have had way more than that, but I kept coming up with the 500. That's fucked up, man. I'm gonna tell y'all some real shit. Any man in here having sex with their baby mama and they on child support, that's prostitution. Straight the fuck up. OK? can't stand my fucking baby mamas. I hate the fuck out of them. Child support is a motherfucker, man. It is, nigga. I'm watching TV the other day and a motherfucking infomercial come on and said, na 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 na. You can feed this beautiful child for 35 cents a day. I turn the TV off, I'm like, 35 cents a day? You can feed a child? Why the fuck my child support $1,000 a month? Shit ain't making no sense, my nigga. See, I wanna say something to all the men in here, man. You gotta fucking strap that thing up. Cause what you don't know, man, pussy is the most powerful drug on the market right now. Look at Chad Ochocinco. This nigga lost his TV show, his goddamn NFL job. He can't get a motherfucking job all over some pussy. It's a lot of women in here right now, like you right there, baby. You don't even know. She's sitting on that heroin right now. Nigga, get off in that, nigga. Be like, ah. 2 minutes go by, nigga. Be like, hey, look, man, I could stay up here all fucking night, but I can't do it, because boss ain't even paid the nigga yet, you know what I mean? Boss my weed, man, you know what I mean? He like, nigga, I'm going to pay you in the eighth, my nigga. I get here, the eighth ain't came. My boss be texting his weed specials and shit, too. You come to the show, buy comedy tickets, you get 2 eighths for 15. But I wanted to come out tonight and just show support, because as black men, we need to work together, mess with one another, man. That's what this shit is about. Supporting one another, putting your ego to the motherfucking side and working with each other, because he may have this on Saturday. I have my spot on Tuesdays at the Luna. You know what I mean? I'm doing things. I got thisis50.com. The radio, all that shit. I'm still going strong, trying to make my dream happen. And that, you know, when you do shows like this, it's a step towards your goal and your dream. So one more time for my man, Boss. I got a hell of a lot of more jokes that I can tell y'all tonight. But Mike was in the back like, goddamn it, nigga, how long you gonna do, though? You know what I mean? Because my people was out there, nigga, and they got naps to take in a few minutes. Pops like. So I'm gonna let Mike come out here, but I'm gonna do this again with Boss definitely, and maybe he can just let me come out here and just fuck y'all up for a 45 hour set. I got it in me to do that for y'all, swear to God. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring Boss back up so I can hurry up and get my man Michael Collier out. I'm Mike P, man. Thank y'all for watching. Hey, I'm a holler.
But with no further ado, I'm gonna bring the man of the hour to the stage. I want y'all to make some noise for this man. This is a man I grew up watching before I ever thought to be a comedian. You know what I mean? And he came here tonight by the grace of God to show me some good love. So I want y'all to put y'all hands together for my man, Mr. Michael Collier.
How y'all doing? Oh, okay. Thanks, brother. Appreciate it, man. I'm gonna be a minute, so you can take a break. Okay. How y'all doing? Shit, I was in the audience having more fun than y'all. I think, first of all, Boss is funny as a motherfucker. He come up here and roasted every motherfucking body. He talked about the DJ, the band's lady, the backup singer, old dude. Everybody get fucked up. Ain't nobody still. Where y'all going? Y'all gonna pee? Lady, y'all gonna... You gonna pee? Okay, wash your hands. Oh, you just gonna get a drink? Bring back a water, just regular water. Just, I don't know, I want no ice. Just, no, just regular water. And I want to say, I was watching all the comics, and they all come out and do a whole lot of profanity and stuff, and I ain't kind of comic just do profanity, just, no, we're not going to film my shit. He made this shit work, he made it happen, and it was fun, because I was sitting in the back watching him, and after watching the shit he pulled off, I know I can come here, do what the fuck I want to do. Ain't no fucking limits, ain't that motherfucker just go, he just fucking go, and I thank you. Where you at, boss? Give boss a big round of applause. Wherever you give a big round, give a big round. Yes! Yes! That's what I'm talking about. And I don't know if they got it or not, but nigga, I love that outfit. When you came out that outfit and that wig, nigga, I'm thinking this nigga's wearing that outfit, a wig, and two pistols. This nigga funny. Okay, so I just want to thank you. Give him another big round of applause for boss. Here's my last thing, and I'm going to get out of here. There is now a national conversation that we no longer need Black History Month. We no longer need Black History Month because we have a black president. Thank you. I'm letting him finish that shit. That's right. You know you better buy one now. He walking with the magazine, but what you can't see on this side is that motherfucker got a pistol, right? On.
That's a sandwich.
Wait. Nigga, the funny shit you said is, what I can do that you can't do is I can smother you. And then your legs, okay, go ahead, I'm sorry. All right, here we go. There's a national conversation that we no longer need Black History Month.